All right, John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com here, and we're showing you my residential suburban garden in a standard neighborhood. So here's my neighbor's house, and you know, they have their standard lawn, and you know, other neighbors have lawns, and you know, actually everybody has a lawn. wait, except my house. My house does not have a lawn. Well, it has a little lawn that we're not watering anymore, so you know, but what I do have is I have 9 raised beds here. And so we're planting them all out in edible foods. And so in this first bed here is an interesting one. Basically, I've used square foot gardening or biointensive gardening techniques in this garden fairly loosely. You know, for example, the lettuce here is planted out at 8-inch spacing. And there's no, in a square foot gardening, they recommend that you put dividers on the soil so you can kind of see the squares. But we just basically went with the same spacing and not necessarily the whole square thing would just make things too complicated. So for fun, you know, for people coming by and they could see it, and when I'm explaining it to show them how it goes, we actually did a square foot garden. So we actually laid out string, and you could actually see the, you know, 1 by 1 foot squares. And this bed is basically 15 feet long by about 4 feet. So we have basically 4 feet, 4 squares across and 15 down. So you can see the planting density of some certain plants that I've planted out so far. For example, a tomato plant there takes 1 full square. And that's gonna be a small patio type tomato, determinate variety, and it's not gonna get very big. So we're using a small cage on that. And so say, for example, this bok choy here, we planted 4 per square. So you can see the square, and there's 4 of them in there. For example, this basil here, there's a 1 in the square because it'll grow out more bushy. And also this cauliflower broccoli plant here is also 1 per square. And then this sugar snap peas, I think I planted 3 just because it would go up each leg of the trellis, although you could plant it actually a little more densely. Let's see, peppers also 1 per square. And this one's really cool. I'm excited about this guy. This guy is actually called wild arugula. And supposedly when I bought it from the nursery, the lady told me that this will keep growing as a perennial. So year round as a perennial. And I'm here in California, Northern California. So we may get a little bit of a freeze, but she says if it does go to flower, pinch off the flowers and it'll keep growing on you. So I've grown regular arugula before and they go to flower. And actually I love to eat the flowers. They're actually quite delicious. But then the plant stops producing. So hopefully this one will maybe even take over this whole front bed, and I'd actually be quite happy if it did. The only other cool and interesting plant I have planted out here is this guy on the end, and I planted it on the end for a reason. We have these big 4x4 posts going up the front, and we're actually gonna put trellis material in there, probably some metal, thick, heavy wire trellis material in between the wood, and this guy will actually probably end up growing up it. And this one's basically related to the tomatillo and tomato, but it's a little bit different. It's called ground cherry, or in Hawaii they call it poha, or they also call it inkenberry. And this guy actually overwintered here in California, here in Northern California, just outside. I think it died down to the root in the back of my house in some shaded areas. It actually lost some leaves and dried out, but it still lived. And if it's in a more protected area, actually it'll grow year-round and fruit year-round. So it'll be an amazing display here. It's gonna pretty much grow up on this whole big tall trellis. I mean, this is about, I think, a 10 foot tall overall, and it, believe me, it will get up there and it's gonna cover the whole thing. You kind of see it's got some flowers already so far. Let me get the flower there for you. Nice flower there. And these fruits, so let me say, the poha berry or inkenberry or cape, they also call them cape gooseberry. To eat the fruits, they're ready when they basically are in the husk and they fall off the plant and fall onto the ground. And they need to be a nice, dark, rich yellow color. I guess if you're eating them raw, of course, and they're going to be the sweetest. Another real cool thing is once they drop off the plant and onto the ground, and it's a nice hot summer day, you forget about them, such as I did, they'll actually get sun-dried on the ground. And oh my God, those things are amazing. So inkenberry, poha berry, Cape gooseberry or ground cherry. They're all called the same thing. Sometimes they're called, what are they called? Yeah. So anyways, great food. It'll actually take over and it could be kind of weedy actually if you don't control it too much. So that's that. And this is the front bed, going square foot gardening style as a demonstration to show people what I'm doing here. So that'll be another episode here at growingyourgreens.com. Thank you so much. This is John Kohler, over and out.